Hello friends, let us now learn some important points about the breath holding spells. Breath holding spells are the paroxysmal events. These are paroxysmal events which occur in almost 0.1 to 5% of children who are in the age group of 6 months to 6 years. So this breath holding mainly occurs during the expiration. In fact, they do breath holding during the expiration, and it is reflex in nature, not voluntary. It is actually reflexive in nature. So there are two types of breath holding spells are present. Two types of breath holding spells can be seen. One, we have cyanotic form, are also called as cyanotic spells, cyanotic form or cyanotic spells. Second, we have pallid form, are also called as pallid spells. So what do you see in cyanotic spells? In cyanotic spells, you will see that here, this is mainly due to the activation of central sympathetic overactivity. Whenever the parents scold the child, the child becomes anxious. The child will have anger and frustration. So this anger and frustration will activate the central sympathetic system. But this becomes overactivated, and as a result, the child develops generalized cyanosis. She develops apnea, forced respiration, forced expiration will be there. Then there will be opisthotonus, shrill cry, and bradycardia are seen. Generalized cyanosis, apnea, forced expiration, opisthotonus, shrill cry, and bradycardia are seen in the child. So this can also lead to cerebral hypoxia. If there occurs cerebral hypoxia because of the cyanosis, then you will see presence of seizures can also occur in the child. The only treatment that is required in these children is you will have to give support and reassurance is given. Support and reassurance is given to the children. This is cyanotic spells. Then the second form is pallid form or pallid spells. So the second form we have is pallid form or pallid spells. These pallid form or pallid spells, these occur whenever the child has a painful experience. So this painful experience will activate the excessive central parasympathetic activity. So these will activate excessive central parasympathetic activity. So this parasympathetic activity will cause pallor, it will cause apnea, loss of consciousness, there will be hypotonia, and there will be again these can also lead to seizure in the baby, and these can be bradycardia can also be there. Anti seizure medications are not recommended in these children. The main treatment is we will have to reassure the child, reassurance should be given, and you will have to support the child. Then in refractory cases, if after giving support and reassurance, if it does not resolve, then you can give atropine, may be used in refractory cases. In some children with breath holding spells, in some cases we can even give iron supplementation can also be given. So this is about the breath holding spells. Thank you for watching.